Hi, and welcome to Talk & Tech. I'm your host, Alejandro. And as you can probably see and hear, we are here at Computex 2024 on ASRock's booth. And with us, we have Edwin today. Hey, Edwin,
Hello.
How's it going?
Nice to meet you. I'm Edwin.
Nice to meet you, too. So what do we have here? I see a bunch of amazing motherboards. Tell us a little bit more about all of them.
So this year at ASRock booth, mainly we're displaying the next generation of Intel platform motherboards. So on this wall, we got everything, all the way from the very flagship, the Taichi Alpha, and we also have some ITX motherboard down there. Yeah, so we got everything at the booth.
That's great. So let's start with the Taichi Alpha. What do you have here? What's new? What's different from what you had before? What changes have you made?
For the next generation, what we are going to do is merge all the Alpha, the OC formula, into the Taichi family. So as you can see over here, we got the Taichi Alpha, we got the Taichi OCF, which means OC formula. And we have a special edition of Taichi OCF Cam 2 version. You can see the weird looking memory modules down here over here. Yeah.
That's pretty neat. So this is completely new. So the Cam 2 DDR5 memory. Yeah. Tell us, what was your reasoning behind having this on a desktop motherboard? Because usually this was kind of designed for laptops. So why is it here on a desktop?
This module is originally designed for the notebooks. It got very small and very compact memory module. And the benefit of that is it's low power and also high frequency. So that's what we want to do. We want to boost the memory frequency of this little module by using the OC formula motherboard.
Wow, I like it. That's pretty cool. I can't wait to see what the performance is and get to test it somewhere. So let's go back a little bit here to the Taichi Alpha. I see that you have, before in the previous version, you had a solid block.
Yes.
But now you just have cover and the VRMs, right?
Yeah. For this motherboard, for this generation, we only have the VRM and also the M.2 module. So you can see this one over here, that's actually water cooling for the M.2 modules. Yeah. The reason why we ditched the CPU water block is because we found out that many people, they sort of just want to install their own CPU water block, not what we provide. So that's why we deleted that. But instead, we give you the water cooling for the M.2 module.
Oh, that makes sense. That makes a lot of sense. Also, I saw something that was pretty interesting here that we'll get a close-up in a little bit. And it is back here in the I/O ports.
Yeah.
Tell me about the USBs.
So this is kind of a bold move because we deleted all the Taipeis. USB ports on the Re-IO and instead replace it with a lot of Type-C ports. The reason why is because we really find that Type-C ports is sort of a trend for a lot of devices. We see MacBooks, they're using all Type-C, Thunderbolt in fact, and we see a lot of mobile devices are using Type-C, so why not?
Yeah, no, that makes completely sense, especially when you're trying to solve the problem of, am I going to plug in the USB correctly or not? Now with the USB-C, no more issues with that.
Yeah.
All right, that's pretty cool. So we have here the Taichi, and you was pretty neat because you were able to open it up and it had a lot of M.2 ports. So how many M.2 ports this guy has?
So for the motherboard itself, it already has six M.2 ports on the motherboard.
On the motherboard.
Yeah.
Can you open it?
Yeah, sure. Quick release design, by the way, for all the M.2 slots. So.
Oh, that's pretty cool. Oh, wow.
Yeah. So for the motherboard, already has six slots. One, two, three, four, five, six. Already six slots. But additionally, we are going to bundle this little guy for every user who buys the Taichi motherboard. So for this adding card, it can support additionally four more M.2 slots. So in total, you will get 10 M.2 on the Taichi motherboard.
That's amazing. That's a lot of M.2s. Yeah. You'll be looking for a lot of storage, maybe building an NAS. That'll be pretty useful. All right, so these are the high end. So I can see you have your Phantom Gaming. Tell us a little bit more about this whole brand.
Yeah, so we also have a full range of Phantom Gaming motherboards, starting from the Nova. We introduced this product line last year in Computex also. Also, we got a Red Tie Wi-Fi and the Lightning Wi-Fi. Yeah, the flagship gaming, for the mainstream, this one's of the entry level. Yeah.
That's great. And he also has the quick release for all of them.
Yeah.
And also this is when you're switching video cards, that's really nice too. Oh, it pulls.
Yeah.
All right. Well, Edwin, thank you very much. Really appreciate it. So right now we're with Divine and we're going to be talking about this amazing video card that we see here.
Yeah.
Yes. Tell us more about your baby. Hi, Devine. How's it going?
Okay. This is our most high-end Intel Arc graphic card, the Intel Arc A770 Phantom Gaming 60GB OC. That with a factory default overclocking, it can provide you higher performance than Intel's reference cards in gaming and in all other like AI applications working. And also, you know, with the old triple fan design, you can get a very, very good heat dissipation. And also we have polychrome sync, the old ARGB light effects. Then with this technology, you can control your ARGB lighting, not only for the graphic cards, but also if you use all the ASRock motherboards, you can build your own whole ARGB light systems.
Nice. No, so I really like it because this is the first time I've seen a triple fan design for an ARC card.
Yes.
And like you were saying before, this one is for gamers, thinking about them. So it has RGBs because, you know, RGBs gives you more frames per second. But what I really like about this card is for the RGB, you can actually turn it on and off. Yes. But it has a physical switch so you can do that.
Yes.
Back here. And to me, I think that's pretty cool because a lot of times you have to actually install some software, but you guys have, you know, kind of listen to the community and be like, hey, we can just install a little switch to turn it off and there you go.
Yes.
This is great. And also you guys not only have like the high end, but you also have the whole stack of different options that you have from this guy, which is a triple fan, all the way to the low profile.
Yes. In Computex, we are showing that we have the whole lineup of our Intel ARC series graphic cards, so you can see up to the A770 and the down to the A380 low profile, the biggest one and also to the smallest one.
Yeah, that's pretty good. Well, Devine, thank you so much. Learned a lot today. All right, so we're here again with Edwin and he has actually a special treat. We were walking around the booth and actually I got to see this and I was very impressed because this is actually immersive cooling using perfluorocarbon in a workstation. You usually see this on a server data center, but now they're actually doing it in a workstation. So Edwin, why don't you tell us a little bit more about this one?
Yeah, just like he said, for this sort of new idea or new concept of how to cool your personal PC or personal workstation. Yeah, because in the past, in a conventional design, no matter it's a water cooling or air cooling, it only cools off like just the CPU, but it actually has some other hotspots on the motherboard, like VRMs. That cannot be cooled. But with this immersion cooling, it actually cools everything inside the system. So it actually provides a more stable or more average temperature for the components. Yeah, as you can see over here, the CPU is running at 100%, but only around 50 degrees for the package temperature. It's very, very low for this kind of workload.
Yeah, this is great. And right now here, we're running a workstation CPU, which is a W9-3495X that actually you can overclock.
Yeah.
And it is really impressive. It really caught my eye because usually these temperatures are what you see at idle, but now at full load and just keep it at like 53, 48 Celsius, it's amazing. I loved it. This is pretty cool. So this is bringing immersive cooling to the workstation.
Yes, personal workstation.
Yep.
Thank you.